The referee has said yes, it's a goal. And Kordic and Probert have dropped the gloves, and they want everybody to move back. They just might go.
And the linesmen are getting a standing boo here for getting in front of both those fellows. I think that was a very slow whistle that Glenn Hanlon had the puck covered. But it doesn't make much difference what I think. Paul Stewart didn't, and he pointed right into the net, and I think you'll see that goal count.
Well, Bob Probert, the league's most penalized player, is being pushed over to a familiar spot, the penalty box, and so is John Kordic. But it was Brian Skrudlin who Probert first became upset with. It was Kordic who piled into the goal crease, and of course, that always starts something. And we have a punchless penalty situation here. Nobody touched anybody, but they're gone, Kordic and Probert. And suddenly things came alive in that way. But after, the Canadians came right back following the Zombo goal and the pileup and the delayed whistle, as Harry says. Puck disappeared for a while. Now let's take a look at it.
Hanlon's got that puck. Skrudlin hit it right out of his glove when it was under it. The referee should have blown the whistle, in my opinion, on that one. And there's the trouble. Probert runs Skrudlin into the net. Hanlon's got it right now. Or has he?
It's Kordic. Kordic gets the goal. He's the one who plows in. And there's when the fun starts. Net comes off. And there's the guy who got it.